We are going to see the play Pygmalion. So first of all, we will see some of the facts related to the author. So who is the author? George Bernard Shaw. He is a famous English playwright. And then we will see some of the facts related to G.B. Shaw. Okay. He was born in 1856 and he died in 1950. Basically around 100 years, I guess. So he is actually an Irish playwright, just like we had Oscar Wilde. We have already studied the importance of being earnest, and we know that he also belongs to the same canon. That is, he just like Bernard Shaw, they later on they were born and brought up in Ireland, and then they came to London, and then they basically wrote from that place, London. Okay, so he's also an Irish playwright, and then he is a co-founder of London School of Economics. I hope everything is fine there. Yeah, actually I'm not that okay. I have a heavy headache, but I thought anyway I will complete this. Okay, fine, no problem. I will somehow we will finish it off, otherwise we will lag a lot behind. So I thought we will it's okay, I will manage it anyway. Okay, thank you. So now we can go, we can see the other informations related to George Bernard Shaw. Okay, then he is a co-founder of the London School of Economics. As you must be familiar with this London School of Economics, it is one of the famous outstandingly good school, I mean school college, that is London School of Economics. It has produced a very humongous or very prestigious alumni. So London School of Economics is very much a famous institution, and then he is one of the co-founders. So he is also an essayist, novelist, and a short story writer. But basically, he is famous for his excellent plays. Okay, now what are the main themes or major issues that major ideas that George Bernard Shaw focuses was these prevailing social problems, like education, marriage, religion, and government, healthcare, class privileges, etc. He is an ardent critic of the systems, basically all the institutions, and then his plays are a critic towards these kind of institutions, like education. Everything is an institution, like education, marriage, religion, government, all of these are institutions, as you know that. So he basically criticizes, or he basically addresses all the problems that prevails in the society at that time. Okay, and he wrote many brochures and speeches for the Fabian Society. Fabian Society is also somewhat found in that time. He was an active member of Fabian Society. It is a middle class socialist group for social transformation. Okay, so basically this is a common question related to George Bernard Shaw. That is, who is a member, who among the below writers is a member or was a member of Fabian Society, that kind of questions you can expect. As you know that there are lots of groups, basically when you learn this literature, you know that there are lots of schools, lots of societies. So it is important that you should understand to which particular group a particular writer belongs to. Okay, so he belongs to this Fabian Society, which is basically a middle class socialist group for social transformation. And his dramas, he categorized them as pleasant and unpleasant. Okay, and this is basically, he wrote an essay as pleasant and unpleasant. Dramas, pleasant and unpleasant was the book, was the essay, and he categorized some of them as very unpleasant and some of them as pleasant. Okay, then he wrote more than 60 plays, and then it's a huge contribution, that is 60 plays. And then he was for a short period of time he was active in local politics. He served in London County Council. Okay, for a very short period. And then he something very interesting about George Bernard Shaw is that he is the only person, only individual who was awarded both Nobel Prize and Oscar Award. So that is something outstanding or a different fact related to George Bernard Shaw. And then he is also considered in literature and in everyday life, people tend to use a lot of specific aphorisms or quotations from his plays, and then basically we call it as Shawian quotes. Okay, Shawian ideas are there, Shawian attitude is there. Even Shawian means a person who is who has an inclination towards this this particular writer. That is so basically the quotes are Shawian quotes. Okay, then chief proponents. He was a chief proponent of problem plays or discussion plays. Okay, that is problem plays or discussion plays are those dramas that deals with realistic problems, real social issues. As we have already saw that he is very much interested in dealing with the social problems. His dramas are basically called as problem plays or discussion plays because he deals with controversial social issues. Okay, and all the dramas are politically and socially committed and then influenced by Henrik Ibsen. Excuse me just a moment, please. I'll fix a problem. Okay.